Progressive Radio.
Hey, wake up!
Broadcasting on 200,000 watts of talk power. Covering Eastern North Carolina. This is where ENC comes to talk.
Ooh, you smell something.
This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton on Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
All right, welcome into Hour 2 of Talk of the Town. It's 5 minutes after 8 this hour of the program, brought to you by Moore's Old Fashioned Barbecue, Moore's Old Time Barbecue. And we are happy that there's going to be a new Old Time Barbecue, Moore's Old Time Barbecue, opening in Swansboro soon. I drove by it the other day, McGee, when I was down in Swansboro.
Cool.
The store's looking good. And, I mean, in Jacksonville, Swansboro's already open. I drove by the Jacksonville location. Jacksonville's almost open, but Swansboro's open. Of course, Moorhead City's open, New Bern's open, and Greenville Winterville is open right up on Memorial Drive just by Sam's Club. And if you have not had my I had my grandson this weekend, and I asked him where he wanted to go, and he said Moore's. He likes their ribs.
Barbecue and white chicken combo.
They have the ribs on Fridays at 4 o'clock.
So he likes ribs?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, good.
Are you kidding? Who doesn't like Moore's ribs? Have you had Moore's ribs?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Moore's Barbecue, they have the ribs starting on Fridays at 4. But they also, the great thing about Moore's, if everybody in your family doesn't want barbecue, they got great hand-picked, cooked fresh barbecue. They cook it fresh every night. You know, the dirty little secret is some of these barbecue places aren't cooking their barbecue every night. I'm not calling any names, but they do at Moore's. They cook overnight every night, and so it's always fresh, and it's always hand-picked. But they have other things like firecracker shrimp. They got tenders. They got great veggies.
Good sandwiches, too.
I love their green beans. So Moore's Old Time Barbecue. You can learn more at their website, mooresoldtimebarbecue.com. And, of course, they're located. Here's a good thing. If you're heading to the beach and you're pulling a boat or you're in an RV, you can pull right behind the Moore's on Highway 70. Go take the Highway 24 entrance, and they've got a big, huge, large vehicle parking area right in the back. All right, the Speaker of the House for the North Carolina General Assembly, the legislature, the Honorable Tim Moore. Speaker Moore is going to be on the phone with us here in just minutes. We were trying to get him yesterday, but we couldn't connect in time because I wanted to get his reaction to this pledge by 47 Democrats in North Carolina to team up with this left-wing PAC that is trying to buy the loyalty of some of the Democrat candidates with a bunch of money. They've dumped $100,000 into different races in the legislature, giving some candidates like Brian Farkas as much as $5,400. The candidates are all now saying that the Republicans are lying about the fact that this is that they have signed on to an organization that's a defund the police organization, but it's in black and white on their website. And the strategy, of course, by the Democrats, they started this with Darren Jackson after Tim Moore had a press conference on Monday night, you know, is to say, this is a lie. Don't believe your lying eyes. Don't, you know, even though our names are all on that, and the website says that they're for defunding the police, don't believe that we're for defunding the police. They've been caught taking money from this organization. And again, I say again to Brian Farkas and Candy Smith, of course, Candy probably doesn't care, but James Galliard, who portends to be a conservative running over there in Rocky Mount, if you don't believe that we should defund the police, give this group their money back. Come out with a statement and denounce their platform. Otherwise, stop saying that the Republicans are lying, because it's not a lie. In fact, the Speaker says they've run a fact check on it, and we're going to talk to Speaker Tim Moore about it coming up in just a few minutes. I promised to mention this a couple more times. For folks who are about my age, maybe a year older, that went to J.H. Rose High School, class of 1970, they were planning a big reunion the weekend of October 3rd. But due to COVID-19, the 50th reunion of the class of 1970 for Rose High is going to be postponed until fall of 2021. So if you need more information, you got questions, you can contact Pat Swindell Tyson at Patty, S-O-N, at suddenlink.net. Patty Sun. Have you seen the new Netflix series that's out? It's an updated version of the Karate Kid. It's called Cobra Kai.
I have not.
Was that your era?
Yeah. I have not.
Did you like the Karate Kid?
I did. I think I paid more attention to it though after, you know, in my mid-teens to upper high school years.
This is a series on Netflix that follows the two main characters, and it's got some of the other characters in it too, like the guy who was the sensei in the movie.
Yep.
He's now like a homeless drunk, but still cocky. I shouldn't say that. I don't want to ruin it for you. But the two guys. Who was the blonde guy that beat Daniel up? Daniel-san. And they have a lot of flashbacks to Mr. Miyagi and stuff like that. But Daniel is now a very successful car dealer in Los Angeles. And he's rich. And he's gotten away from karate, but he comes back to it because his arch nemesis, what was the guy's name?
I'm looking right now.
Reopens Cobra Kai. So if you haven't seen, I remember that, but I really watched it because my kids were into it in the 80s.
Yeah.
But our friend Peter Cetera, of course, did the theme song, The Glory of Love. And somebody here in the office told me the other day that song actually shows up in the series at some point. Now, I haven't watched the series. My Johnny, thank you, Jake. The great Jake Jacobs says it's Johnny who was Daniel's arch nemesis. So if you're into that era, if you're into the 80s movies and you want to, I tell you, my daughter, who grew up in the 80s, is just enamored. She can't stop watching it. She's been binge watching it.
I checked it out then. If it's that good. It's one that I could watch over and over again when I was younger. If I saw it, you know, one week, I could watch it 2 weeks later, and it never really got old. I'd always watch it if it was on.
Yeah. Let's see. What have I not gotten to this morning that I wanted to mention? I guess the kids are in school now. I wanted to wait until maybe the kids were all out of the car before I talked about this one.
Most are online.
Oh, that's true. They're not going to school. So this is
now what day is it? It's Wednesday.
This might be a little bit of a. An earmuff alert here. Let's see if I can get this to work. There's an article online this morning that the FBI has now raided the home of one of Joe Biden, one of the people that's been out on the campaign trail. They call him a YouTube influencer, a young black guy by the name of Jerry Harris. Now, I did not watch the Netflix documentary Cheer, but if you watched that, you may know who Jerry Harris is. But Monday afternoon, federal agents stormed his home because they had learned that he was allegedly sending messages and explicit photos to minors, soliciting them for bad intentions. I'll leave it like that. This guy's 21 years old. Just 3 months ago, the Biden campaign was having Harris, who has a million followers on Instagram, get online and try to sway voters and win back the internet, is the way they put it. Time magazine reported the Instagram live video of Harris and Biden was viewed nearly 300,000 times. Biden got on with Harris and did this give and take, and so the Biden campaign's been all over this guy trying to get him to influence young black voters. And And then on Monday, whoops, the FBI breaks into his home and raids his home and finds all sorts of videos and explicit photos and things like that. And he apparently is in big trouble for soliciting minors. So that's there's one of your Biden supporters this morning. What kind of a driver are you, McGee? I found this interesting this morning.
You know, I don't like to boast about many things, but I think I'm a darn good driver.
Have you had wrecks?
No.
Never?
Oh, well, I'll take that back. I did.
Never had a fender bender?
One fender bender.
How many speeding tickets have you had?
Zero.
In your life?
My life.
Michael, how many speeding tickets have you had in your life?
One.
Really? How fast were you going?
I was doing 65 and a 55 on 264.
Was it recent?
No, it's been 20 years ago.
That car you got won't go 65.
Oh, yeah. The car I got will go 92.
92.
It'll go 92.
92.
Okay, so I'm a bad driver. I admit it. But I once read, you know, when I was doing sales training back in probably in the 80s, one of the things that I learned, I've talked about this before, there was a program called PACE, P-A-C-E, Personal and Corporate Effectiveness. And it was a program that trained people how to be more effective in their life and in their business. And I got so enamored with that. A guy named Jerry Newman out of California had developed that program. And when I was working for Vilcom, when I became vice president of Vilcom Communications, I actually became the guy that they'd go to train people with this stuff. And so I would kind of facilitate it for other employees. And one of the things in that program that I learned is that every personality, he says that there are four distinct personalities. And he puts them in terms of colors, red, yellow, green, or blue. So I am clearly a red because I'm a type A personality. I tend to be a little boisterous. I might be overbearing from time to time. it's hard to admit that about myself, but let's face it, that's type A's for you. But he said one of the characteristics of red personalities is, you know, they drive too fast, that they're not great drivers. And so I have incorporated, when I'm interviewing salespeople and I want people who, you know, have the courage to go and ask people to spend money with our stations and all that, I always ask them, what kind of driver are you? And it's a trick question because they all want to tell you, oh, I'm a great driver. I'm a great driver. So I'm like, how many speeding tickets have you had? And, you know, if they ever tell me, no speeding tickets, I'm like, you can't sell. So, I mean, how does that match up with your personality? I mean, it doesn't. It's just a personality trait. It doesn't mean it's not good or bad about you. It's just who you are.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
So it's kind of like a Myers-Briggs, but this goes deeper than Myers-Briggs. And, you know, I'm going to say that you and again, it's not judgmental because it just shows the difference in our personalities. And
I drive fast, and I've been pulled for speeding, but I didn't get a ticket.
Oh, now you're changing the story.
Well, I mean, I didn't get the ticket. Yes, I got a speeding ticket.
You talked him out of it, didn't you?
If you recall, the first one I ever got pulled, first time I got pulled, I cried, and I guess it worked.
How old were you?
I was 16.
You cried?
I cried. I've admitted this on the air.
You cried?
I've admitted this on the air. I did. Tears began to roll because I was so concerned about what my dad would do to me when I got home. And I told the officer that. I said, he is going to kill me. And as I was telling him this, then it morphed into tears and choking up and that kind of thing. And yeah. And he let me go.
I'm getting texts from all my friends.
He let me go.
People are texting me saying, I haven't had any speeding tickets. Tom Lamprick says, didn't McGee hit a cow once?
Thank you, Tom. thank you for calling that.
Did you hit a cow?
Years ago. Yeah, years ago.
You hit a poor cow?
I sure did. I killed the cow, as a matter of fact.
You did?
I did.
Did you have steak for dinner?
No. No, I didn't. Right there on Highway 11, right down from Smitty's.
No kidding.
Years ago. Yeah. Thank you, Tom.
Yeah.
Tom, you're no longer allowed to text during the show.
David says, lots of speeding tickets also indicate you have no golf swing. That's. Oh, my friend Travis says, I've had 31. Travis, that would not surprise me about you. Mike says, I've had three. The great Denny Booker, county commissioner in Craven County, says his wife Diane has been driving for 60 years. She wants you to know she's had zero tickets. All right, so here's the thing. Again, it's not about whether you're good or bad. It's just a personality trait. So, you know, it's one of the probably negative traits of being a red personality and a type A, but I am.
How do you correlate? How can someone not sell if they don't have speeding tickets? How do you make that correlation?
It's just got to do with this program that I'm talking about. He says that one of the characteristics of good sales, the Reds are the best salespeople. The Reds. So if you're a Red, and again, all those things I talked about, you're the center of attention. You want to be the center of attention. I mean, this is me all the way around.
It is.
You're a little loud. You're very courageous.
You're personable.
Personable.
You talk to anyone.
Yeah, right. And so this is the trait of a Red, and these are the best salespeople according to this program that I used to be a part of, PACE program.
I don't know about the driving part though, but everything else.
I absolutely believe it. Daryl is on the phone. Good morning, Daryl. Are you a good driver?
No.
There you go. Are you a good salesperson?
Oh, I'm an excellent salesperson.
There you go.
I've got a record though. So way back in the 80s when I was a young man, I got a DWI.
Oh boy.
And back then it was just
That's a different issue there.
Back then it was a 90-day suspension.
Yeah.
Okay. Took my license away for 90 days. Got my license.
But you learned your lesson, right? You never did it again.
No, sir. I got a DWI that day. I got my license back.
Say that again?
It was a 90-day suspension back then.
Yeah.
I got my license back. The day I got my license back, I got a DWI.
I'm not sure I would tell this story if I were you.
Wait, so you had two.
I am not sure I would tell this story.
That's
the record. Why are you calling in to tell this? Have you taken
said.
Care of your issues, I hope?
Yeah, nothing said.
Okay. Well, thanks for that call.
All right.
David will remain anonymous.
That's why they call it Talk of the Town, people. Because you don't know what's going to happen when people call in and talk. Here's what I'm leading up to. There's a story this morning. We never got to the survey. Survey found the top signs you're a bad driver. Okay, here they are. Number one, excessive speeding. 61% said it means you're a bad driver. But over 40% admitted that they like to drive fast. One in three think of speed limits as just a suggestion. Number two sign that you're a bad driver. You cut people off. 54% say that's, yeah. Number three, tailgating. God, I hate that when somebody tailgates me. Sometimes I just slam on the brakes. That's probably not a good strategy, is it?
No. Mm-mm.
Number four, constant road rage. My wife says I have road rage. Again, I'm a Red.
Yeah. See, I'm impatient, which is kind of like having road rage.
Here's one. If you're sitting behind somebody at a stoplight and the light turns green, do you blow your horn or do you just sit there?
Blow it as hard as you can.
Yeah. I can tell you right now, if you're in front of me and the light's green, you're getting the horn.
All right, I think if you
don't blow the horn, you're a wimp.
I'm with you, especially. I might give you a 2-second buffer, but after that, you got to go and go.
Here's what happens. If I look and see the light screen, somebody's in front of me sitting at the light, and the light screen, I look at their head, and if I see they're looking down, I'm like, eh!
Yeah.
I will absolutely blow the horn out.
Here's the Wilson trait. They stop at green lights. I've only seen this in Wilson City. They stop at green lights.
Why do they do that?
I have no idea. Infuriates me to no end.
Not using turn signals, 38%. Driving with one hand on the wheel. Is that dangerous? I do that.
I did that too. Here's one that gets me, and I'll admit to this. if you're driving and for some reason maybe you're driving too slow, you're being careful, but someone behind you wants to get around you, and they get mad with you ultimately, and they drive by you and they give you the, you know, one of the fingers, or they make a gesture at you. Mm-hmm. I don't feel like I can let that go. And so I have to catch them and do it back to them just to make me feel better
about
it.
You shoot people the bird?
If I get it from them.
Hey, that's dangerous these days.
I know it is. I know.
Don't shoot people the bird.
Or just anything that they might do. Give me a look. If they give me a look, I'm going to give them a look back.
All right, let's get a break here.
I can't let it go.
I'm telling you. See, to me, if you're sitting behind somebody at the stoplight and the light turns green, and you don't blow the horn immediately, you're probably not going to be a good salesperson. You're not a red, baby. I'm a red, and I'm proud of it. We'll be right back.
Get out and drive at Greenville Toyota. We'll get you out of your trade with up to thousands more than it's worth. We need trades now more than ever, and we'll pay you more for your trade than you ever thought possible. It's time to get out and drive at Greenville Toyota.
Top Dog Academy provides training services and daycare for dog owners in and around Greenville. The Top Dog facility, located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bellsport, is a comfortable, healthy environment where dog owners can feel secure about leaving their pets. Top Dog Academy teaches people how to have a better relationship with their dog. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
My name is Dr. Neeti Armistead, Chief Medical Officer for Vidant Health. The following simple steps will help keep you and your community safe. Stay home as much as possible, wear a mask when out in public, avoid large gatherings, practice social distancing, and wash hands often. It's also important not to delay needed care. Vidant has taken important steps to provide you and your family with a safe environment. Learn more about COVID-19 and Vidant's response. Call 252-847-8000 or visit vidanthealth.com/COVID-19.
Hunger and poverty starts here. Your gift of an animal from Heifer International can help a family start a small business, creating food and income for education, medicine, and more, all while caring for the earth around the world and right here at home. Heifer International. Learn more at heifer.org.
This is a radiated tortoise. Because of the support from AZA, I'm able to put these endangered tortoises back into the wild.
When I was younger, watching scuba divers conserve these magnificent creatures, I wanted to be a part of that.
I work in Hawaii with critically endangered forest birds. Birds are so interesting to me because they're living dinosaurs. I love working with them.
I know I always wanted to work with kids, and I fell in love with the animals and conservation side. It's exactly where I'm supposed to be.
Won't you join us?
Greenville Toyota wants you to get out and drive. We'll get you out of your old car so you can drive a Corolla, 149, RAV4s, 219. Plus, get out of maintenance fees and drive with the Greenville Advantage at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
I told you 3 times to take out the garbage!
Your kids may not be listening, but every voice-activated smart device is. Just tell it to play WTIB on TuneIn Radio. Now, back to Henry Hinton and Talk of the Town on Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
After 8 o'clock, and we're in the studio this morning again tomorrow morning live in Edenton. Lieutenant Governor Dan Forrest will join us live in Edenton tomorrow morning on the Edenton waterfront. We hope everybody in that area, northeastern North Carolina, will come down and be with us tomorrow morning. And then Friday morning, we will be there at the brand new Sawyer's Fun Park, and TJ Sawyer is going to have free breakfast for everybody. So come to Sawyer's Fun Park out on Corey Road, right next to Boyd Lee Park. And you will be part of the grand opening and the ribbon cutting, which will come at 9 o'clock on Friday morning. But TJ, is they got a full-scale restaurant in there and bar. And if you've not seen the new Family Fun Park here in Greenville, you are going to be really impressed with Sawyer's Fun Park, and we'll be there live on Friday morning. Okay, we've been talking a lot this week about this the fact that there are 47 Democrats. Some of them are candidates, some of them are sitting members in the legislature, most in the House, I believe, that have associated themselves with this Future Now Political Action Committee, which now has, as part of its platform, to defund the police. This fund, it's been hard to trace where the money's coming from, but at the end of the day, you can probably believe that it's George Soros money. But it's being pumped into North Carolina to the tune of over $100,000, like $50,000 to the House Democrat caucus. And then other candidates have received donations from this PAC, up to $5,400, including Brian Farkas, who's running right here in Pitt County against Perrin Jones in District 9. And the part of the mission of this organization is to defund the police. Now, Darren Jackson, the head of the Democrat caucus, has been trying to spin this back, saying that the Republicans are lying about it. Perrin Jones, in the Chamber of Commerce debate yesterday with Perrin Jones, Brian Farkas in the debate with Perrin Jones yesterday, said Perrin Jones was lying about this. So it's now been fact-checked by the newspapers here in North Carolina, and I wanted to get the Speaker of the House on the air this morning to talk about that. Tim Moore, the Speaker of the House for the North Carolina Legislature, joins us this morning. Good morning, Mr. Speaker. How are you?
Good morning, Henry. Good to be with you today. Hope all is well in Greenville this morning.
Yes, sir. And I hear you're coming to town sometime this week, right? You're going to be in Greenville this week?
I will. I'll be in Greenville tomorrow. We have going to be down at the in Little Washington for the Reagan Day dinner there, but I'll have some meetings in Greenville tomorrow afternoon as well.
Oh, good.
And so going to come there. I'll be there in support of Perrin Jones as well.
All right. Well, I hope to see you while you're in town. We need to do one of these on-site morning shows with you. We got Dan Forrest tomorrow morning up in Edenton. We had Mark Robinson. We had like 200 people down in Moorhead City for Mark Robinson a couple of weeks ago. So we need to kind of schedule one of these. These are a lot of fun. You get to meet a lot of people, and so we'll see if we can get on your calendar for that. But let's talk about this defund the police organization that all these Democrats have now associated with. I know that some of them are saying we signed on in 2018, and at that time their platform didn't have anything about defund the police. But a lot of these new Democrats, these new candidates, have signed on in 2020, and it's unclear when this Future Now organization started their defund the police efforts. But, you know, they say you're lying about this, Mr. Speaker. They're calling the Republicans liars about this. Sounds a little desperate to me. I'd probably try to come up with something like that, too, if I'd signed on with this group.
Well, I guess when you've been caught red-handed, that's all you can say. You know, not one of these House Democrats have come forward and said that they didn't sign on to the pledge. Well, of course they did. This is a radical left organization. That is pumping hundreds of thousands of dollars into North Carolina with one goal, and that is to elect liberals to the North Carolina legislature. And I'll tell you, there are a couple of folks who signed on to this thing that I know that I serve with, and I'm really disappointed in it. I've asked them to actually come back and disavow it. But I'll tell you, I know Representative Galliard up in Nash County signed on to this same thing, and now he's trying to walk it back, try attacking me over it. Look, here's what happened. These folks in law enforcement know about this organization, and they started seeing that you had North Carolina House Democrats signing on to this thing, and they were terrified of that because they know what that means. They know that that means less money to police departments, less money to sheriff's offices, less money for example, like school resources. This organization does not even want law enforcement to be able to receive riot gear from the government. I mean, this is a radical organization. And the fact that North Carolina House Democrats, I guess desperate for money or whatever it is, signed on to this group absolutely shocked me. I'll tell you, Henry, when I was first told about it, I thought, surely this isn't right. This can't be right. But you know, the website's there. I mean, the website's there for everyone to see. And the folks who have signed the pledge, their names are there. I mean, this is not something I created. This is a website that for this organization. And they have put hundreds of thousands of dollars in here. But here's the thing. It's more than just a concept, Henry. They actually have on their website, attached to the where the pledge is done, model legislation. And that model legislation includes this, they call it, quote, reallocation of money from policing to other services. Well, that's defunding. I'm going to put it to you this way. If I went on and had a press conference and said that, and I was to say that we were going to reallocate teacher pay, don't you think that'd get people's attention? That means you're taking it from something and putting it somewhere else. Well, and they're trying to spin it. But you know what? It ain't working. Everybody knows that they're just not being truthful. So here's what I meant. Here's what I think the Democrats who signed it ought to do. Number one, if they did sign it, then they just need to take a stand and say, you know what? Yeah, they did sign it, and they do want to cut police funding, and they need to explain to the voters why. But you know what? If they signed it and they're looking at it and going, that isn't really what they intended, it's real easy. They can disavow it. They can send a clear message to this radical left organization that they're not going to sign on to this kind of left-wing agenda. They're going to send back the money. They need to send back all this money that's been sent in here to try to buy these elections, and they need to do it now. That's all they have to do. And I'll tell you something. If those House Democrats will stand up and say that, I'll stand side by side and thank them for that, because this is about what's best for North Carolina. It's not about, you know, winning and losing. And I think we need to send a clear message in this state to all these outside leftist organizations that North Carolina is not going to be like Portland. We're not going to be like Seattle. We're not going to be like areas that are not going to support our law enforcement. That North Carolina is a state where our people can feel safe and secure. And I think that they did that and sent that message. That's an opportunity, even during a campaign season, that we can all stand together and say no to these absolute leftist organizations. So that's my invitation to those Democratic members who were upset. They know it's true. They signed it. They know they did. They know it's there. But you know what? Come clean on it. Let's work together on it. And let's tell this organization they have no place in North Carolina.
You know, what's really infuriating to me about it, we had a Chamber of Commerce debate here yesterday between Perrin Jones, who represents the House in District 9, and Brian Farkas, the Democrat candidate. And, you know, he's taking up Darren Jackson's position on this and spinning it and saying, and actually calling Perrin Jones a liar about it and all that. But, I mean, here are the facts of the matter. And I said this earlier this morning. Let's say that they got caught with their pants down here, that they took this money and then this group came up with this defund the police thing after they took the money. Fine. You don't agree with it or you do agree with it. If you do agree with it, own it. If you don't agree with it, disavow it, put out a statement that you don't agree with these people, and give them the money back, right? Because it's clear
on their
website, on this group's website, it says that the people who signed this pledge have signed it with the agreement that they will work to achieve everything that these folks on this website and this organization want in the legislature by the year 2030. They've even given a deadline as to when they're supposed to have this done. So that means Brian Farkas has taken money from a group that says we want to defund the police by 2030. So here's what I'd say to Brian Farkas and James Galliard and Candy Smith and all the folks here in Eastern North Carolina listening to us this morning that have taken the money, own it. If you don't give the money back, own it, or put out a statement, give the money back, and disavow this left-wing radical group that you're now associated with. That's my message, Mr. Speaker. You agree with that?
You are 100% correct. And, you know, and it's not just, by the way, it's not just their provision about cutting funding to law enforcement. They've got, these folks have also signed on to what's called red flag laws. They've signed on to other gun control measures. They've also, as a part of this, by being endorsed with this group and being affiliated, they're opposed to cash bond. That means if someone goes and breaks in your house, they don't think to be released from jail that they ought to have to post a bond. I mean, this is a. I mean, the more you dig into this group, the more I'm thinking. And again, these are. I know in the context of politics, everything goes back and forth. But look, there are a lot of folks on the other. I mean, a lot of my Democratic members I'm friends with. I mean, I like these folks. I admit I like the fact that everyone in this House takes time away from their family, their jobs, everything to be here serving. And I've talked to a few of them and said, what are you thinking? Why would you sign on to this? Do you really think this is a good agenda item for North Carolina? Have Democrats in this state really gone that far? I mean, are they more liberal than Democrats in California, if that's possible? But I mean, that because these
what kind of answers did you get?
Well, I won't disclose conversations with one-on-one members, but I think there's a little bit of heartburn with a lot of them that they did this, and I think they maybe felt pressured to by their caucus leadership, which has certainly taken a very hard left tilt in the last few years.
Yep.
But you know what, Henry, at the end of the day, it's up to the voters. The voters can decide, do they want to elect, for example, down in your district, do they want to elect a liberal like Brian Farkas, who's going to come up here to Raleigh and going to advocate for cutting money to law enforcement? Where you've got a guy like Perrin Jones who's there. I mean, this guy's a physician. He's there working every day to save lives of people in Eastern North Carolina. He's been consistent. I mean, it's just, when I'm down there Thursday, maybe we'll do a press event with Perrin. You know,
that's a
really
great
talk
idea.
About this,
yeah.
Get it out there because I think the people in Eastern North Carolina need to see exactly what those Democratic members and candidates have signed there in Eastern North Carolina.
Well, I mean,
they've got time if they want to back away from it. They've got time to do that, and that would be if they don't agree with defunding the police, then disavow the group and send back the money.
In fairness to Farkas, in the debate yesterday with the Chamber of Commerce had a Zoom forum with he and Perrin Jones. He got angry about it and said that he has advocated for more funding for the police, that he's never said that he wanted to defund the police. But here is my message. You are now associated with a group that has a goal of defunding the police, and you took money from them, and you've signed a pledge with them to get their agenda accomplished by 2030. Give the money back. Either give the money back or own it. You can't have it both ways, Mr. Farkas. I mean, that's just the way it is. All right, I got to ask you about the ruling yesterday, a federal court yesterday, actually a appeals court yesterday at the Fourth Circuit ruled in favor of you. This was the Tim Moore versus the NAACP lawsuit regarding voter ID. Here we are again with voter ID and the courts getting in the middle, but finally a favorable ruling for you and the Republicans on voter ID. But again, people need to understand that what happened yesterday at the Fourth Circuit Court of Appeals does not mean that that voter ID is going to actually be in place this year, correct?
That is correct. And I'll tell you, voter ID, Henry, is a bill that I worked on for years. It is a bill that is what makes North Carolina like the other, like roughly, I think, 38 other states that have some form of voter ID. And we really worked hard on this. But you know what's really important? At the end of the day, the voters of this state went to the ballot box and approved a constitutional amendment. Yet, you have, again, liberal Democratic judges who had struck this down in state court, struck it down initially in federal court, and as it works its way up, and if you actually get a tribunal to hear it that doesn't have a political agenda, they need to recognize that this is what the voters chose. How can something that's a part of our state constitution, like voter ID, that has been upheld in other states around the country by the U.S. Supreme Court and other courts, how can that be unconstitutional? The fact is, it isn't. And when judges decide that they want to pass laws and they want to be legislators, that is tyranny. I don't know any other way to describe it, because they're using the cloak of justice and of a court case to push a political agenda, and that is wrong. And it is an insult. It is an insult to the 10 million voters or 10 million people of this state and the voters who went and approved by an overwhelming majority this constitutional amendment for voter ID. So I like the fact that we won at the victory at the Court of Appeals. We're very concerned about what's going to happen at the state Supreme Court, which is why in the election this fall, I think it's very important that folks elect conservatives to the state Supreme Court.
Yeah, I'm going to say this now becomes a white-hot topic for the Supreme Court elections coming up. I mean, we've just seen time and time. And look, Cooper vetoes good legislation. The Supreme Court backs him up on all this stuff. We've got a Supreme Court problem in this state. You've got a 6-1 margin now, victory for the majority for the liberals. Paul Newby is running for Supreme Court Chief Justice. Even if the conservatives can't take back the court, if Paul Newby is elected, at least he can control the agenda somewhat. So people don't need to forget when they're thinking about who they're going to vote for in this upcoming election, these Supreme Court justices, particularly the Chief Justice, Mr. Speaker.
Absolutely. These elections are very, very important. And we have three amazing individuals running for the Supreme Court. Of course, Paul Newby, who's on the court and running for Chief Justice. Cameron Berenger, who is a law professor and former state senator here running. And then Phil Berger Jr., a former prosecutor, currently a judge of the Court of Appeals. Absolutely impeccable resumes. But you know what you get when you elect these folks as justices of the Supreme Court? You get folks who will actually simply apply and enforce the laws. They won't be creating laws. And you know what? That's all any of us should ever ask of any judge in this state or elsewhere.
Yeah. Tim Moore, Speaker of the House. Mr. Speaker, thank you much. Travel safely when you're coming east and speaking tomorrow night in Washington at the Reagan Day dinner. And I hope that maybe I'll have a chance to catch up with you sometime tomorrow afternoon while you're here in town when I'm back in town from my Edenton visit tomorrow. Good talking to you today.
That would be great. Good talking with you as well. Take care, Henry.
Okay. Tim Moore, the Speaker of the House. 8:46. We'll be right back.
Get out and drive at Greenville Toyota. We'll get you out of your trade with up to thousands more than it's worth. We need trades now more than ever, and we'll pay you more for your trade than you ever thought possible. It's time to get out and drive at Greenville Toyota.
Top Dog Academy provides training services and daycare for dog owners in and around Greenville. The Top Dog facility, located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bellsport, is a comfortable, healthy environment where dog owners can feel secure about leaving their pets. Top Dog Academy teaches people how to have a better relationship with their dog. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
My name is Dr. Neeti Armistead, Chief Medical Officer for Vidant Health. The following simple steps will help keep you and your community safe. Stay home as much as possible, wear a mask when out in public, avoid large gatherings, practice social distancing, and wash hands often. It's also important not to delay needed care. Vidant has taken important steps to provide you and your family with a safe environment. Learn more about COVID-19 and Vidant's response. Call 252-847-8000 or visit vidanthealth.com/COVID-19.
Hunger and poverty starts here. Your gift of an animal from Heifer International can help a family start a small business, creating food and income for education, medicine, and more, all while caring for the earth around the world and right here at home. Heifer International. Learn more at heifer.org.
This is a radiated tortoise. Because of the support from AZA, I'm able to put these endangered tortoises back into the wild.
When I was younger, watching scuba divers conserve these magnificent creatures, I wanted to be a part of that.
I work in Hawaii with critically endangered forest birds. Birds are so interesting to me because they're living dinosaurs. I love working with them.
I know I always wanted to work with kids, and I fell in love with the animals and conservation side. It's exactly where I'm supposed to be.
Won't you join us?
Greenville Toyota wants you to get out and drive. We'll get you out of your old car so you can drive a Corolla, 149, RAV4s, 219. Plus, get out of maintenance fees and drive with the Greenville Advantage at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money. Yeah, we don't even know what the heck he's talking about either.
It's just a bunch of mumbo jumbo. It's not important.
Remember, there will be a test.
Back to Henry Hinton and Talk of the Town on Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
New North Carolina presidential election poll out from the Trafalgar Group this morning. Pretty much the same numbers as the ECU poll 2 weeks ago. Trump up 2, 47.8 to Biden 46.1. The thing that's a head scratcher, and I know this was taken before the debate night before last, but they also have Cal Cunningham up. But now less than a point. They've got him up at 0.8. So, I mean, it's a statistical tie. Cunningham at 46.1, Tillis at 45.3. But this was before the debate, so we'll see if those numbers hold true. Let's do our Pirate Report right now. Pirate Report this hour, brought to you by our friends at Duplin Winery. If you want some of that great Muscadine wine, look for Duplin Winery Wines in the grocery store in the wine department. 7:50 right now. Here's McGee with our Pirate Report.
ECU practiced in full pads Tuesday for the first time since its final preseason scrimmage they held last Friday. On Tuesday, head coach Mike Houston said his team was down to one active COVID-19 case, and he does not anticipate that player being available for the UCF game next Saturday. Kickoff for that game set for 12 noon and can be seen via ESPN+. NBA playoffs from Tuesday night. The Nuggets overcame a 3-1 deficit. They beat the Clippers Wednesday night to advance to the Western Conference Finals, where they take on the Lakers. And in game one of the East Finals, a big block by Bam Adebayo late in that game, or should say in overtime, lifted the Heat to a 117-114 win over the Celtics. Major League Baseball will have a bubble format for the playoffs. The World Series and NLCS will be in Arlington, Texas, and the ALCS will be in San Diego. The AL Division Series will be in San Diego and Dodger Stadium. The NL Division Series will be in Arlington and Houston. And the NCAA Division I Council is set to meet today to discuss the start of the college basketball season. The committee is expected to approve a start date for conferences and approve parameters relating to football. It was going to be in late November. Could be moved up a little bit now. We'll see what the council does today.
And the Big Ten still talking about playing football starting October 10th.
Yesterday, and there was.
Yeah, they didn't vote again. They met and didn't vote, but, I mean, the word is they're going to approve it. They're waiting to try to drag a few of them in. But, you know, so unfair to the coaches and players.
I know.
You know, these start-stop. I mean, are they practicing? I mean, how are they getting ready for a season that's going to start in a few weeks?
Yeah, it's
crazy. And, again, game time for ECU at noon.
12 noon.
A week from Saturday here in Dowdy Fifflin Stadium, but nobody can go. They're saying 50 people. Mike Houston said yesterday they're going to allow 50 people in. They're going to prioritize their families of the players.
Yeah.
All right, let's get our last break in, and we'll come back and close things out here for our Thursday Talk of the Town. 8:52, more coming up right after this.
Greenville Toyota wants you to get out and drive. We'll get you out of your old car so you can drive a Corolla, 149, RAV4s, 219. Plus, get out of maintenance fees and drive with the Greenville Advantage at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
With Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your day plays here.
My name
name is Dr. Neeti Armistead, Chief Medical Officer for Vidant Health. The following simple steps will help keep you and your community safe. Stay home as much as possible, wear a mask when out in public, avoid large gatherings, practice social distancing, and wash hands often. It's also important not to delay needed care. Vidant has taken important steps to provide you and your family with a safe environment. Learn more about COVID-19 and Vidant's response. Call 252-847-8000 or visit VidantHealth.com/COVID-19.
All right, football watchers, let's do this. It's time for the opening kickoff. Click on, click off. Click on, click off. Come on, Sarah, just a little bit more thumb. Now it's time for leg extenders. One, two, three, relax. And now for the second half sip off. Lift, pull, open, drink.
What if you have to go shopping on game day?
Shopping on game day?
Get out and drive at Greenville Toyota. We'll get you out of your trade with up to thousands more than it's worth. We need trades now more than ever, and we'll pay you more for your trade than you ever thought possible. It's time to get out and drive at Greenville Toyota.
All right, talk of the town on 96.3 and 103.7. We are pretty much done for the day. I'm going to enjoy this beautiful day today. Get on up to Edenton, spend the night at the Cotton Gin Inn with the best bed and breakfast in America. Have breakfast tomorrow morning with Cheryl, then we're going to go down and do the show on the waterfront, so we hope everybody will come. I might get there in time just to kind of walk around tonight because it's such a nice day. We do anticipate being on the waterfront tomorrow morning. There will be tents set up. I know that rain is in the forecast for later in the day. We could get a shower in the morning as well. If we decide to change the location of the Edenton broadcast, we will announce it by 5 this afternoon on social media. So check my Facebook page. And also we'll let Tom Lamprecht know so he can announce it as well. But I think we'll probably be on the waterfront. I'm feeling pretty good about it. So see you in Edenton tomorrow morning, one of the prettiest towns in America. We're looking forward to being there tomorrow morning. Hope to see you there.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
My name is Dr. Neeti Armistead, Chief Medical Officer for Vidant Health. The following simple steps will help keep you and your community safe. Stay home as much as possible, wear a mask when out in public, avoid large gatherings, practice social distancing, and wash hands often. It's also important not to delay needed care. Vidant has taken important steps to provide you and your family with a safe environment. Learn more about COVID-19 and Vidant's response. Call 252-847-8000 or visit VidantHealth.com/COVID-19.
Mom, I'm so bored.
The most music for your workday with Mark, Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your workday plays here.
That she was up for adoption, she was dead set on, no, I need to just be realistic about my life and what my future holds.
That's when she came to me and she said, would you be interested in us adopting you? I didn't think that I would have a family again. I didn't think that I would go to college. I didn't think that I would have love. And with that, I just feel like my world is just so much brighter.
We are a team. We are a unit. We are a family.
No, literally. We are a suburban family of football fans. That's our neighbor. Hi, Bob. And that's the inflatable screen we forgot to properly secure.
Pepsi, made for football. Watch it.